Hi students, in last class we discussed about some experiment like bean seeds. Which soil is suitable for germination of bean seeds? Okay, I hope you read the experiments, and in today class we are going to discuss what Arvind want to investigate. What Arvind want to investigate, how Arvind uses process skills, and what Sweta want to investigate, how Sweta uses process skills. What Sweta plan to investigate, and how Sweta uses process skills.
Holder, and there is small switch is there,
and in when he starts the switch on, this bulb will glow. When the switch will off, the bulb will not glow. Even in our home also, when we on the switch, the bulb will glow. When we on the switch, the fan will rotate. So he did this experiment, a small experiment using some process skills. What process skills? Use some models, collected the materials, predicts. What are the predicts? When the connection is joined, when the switch is on, the light started glowing. When the switch off, the light is not glowing. For this simple we can write, so if the switch is on, the light is flowing, the electricity is flowing, that's why the light is glowing. If the switch is off, the light will not glow. This is my experiment. Next one is, what Sweta planned to investigate? Sweta also she started thinking, she want to buy a quality of towel. If she wants to buy a quality of towel, she must know which towel is quality of towel. How she know that? Doing or using some process skills, she can know the quality of towels. This is a small experiment. She took 3 beakers. In 3 beakers, she have taken water, 1 liter of water. So she have taken 3 beakers containing 1 liter of water. 1 liter is about 1000 ml of water. And she can take 100 ml of water, our wish. And she took, she uses some process skills. What process skills she uses? Hypothesis. First process skill is hypothesis. She collected three different types of towels, 3 different quality of towels, plan and conducting the experiment. Finally, conclusion. How she conclude? Take 3 beakers containing 100 ml of water, or we can take 1000 ml of water in each beaker, and take 3 different types of towels, like cotton towels, like polyester, like different types of towels we can take, and place these towels in the first beaker. So in the second beaker it is a different towel, and the third beaker it's a different towel. 3 different types of towels she has taken, and she kept around 10 seconds is enough to absorb the water. She kept all the different towels in each beaker, then 10 seconds she started observing very carefully, plan and conduct the experiment. Now after doing this experiment, she remove the towels from the beaker and she draining all the 3 towels, and she started measuring the water present in the beaker. She started measuring the water present in the beakers. Now you can say, in A beaker, B beaker, C beaker. In A beaker, if she taken 100 ml of water, if only 50 ml of water is remain. In B beaker, 40 ml of water is remain. In C beaker, only 10 ml of water is remain. What is the conclusion? Which towel is quality of towel? How can we say? So first beaker towel absorb 50 ml of water, and the second beaker towel absorb 60 ml of water, and third beaker towel absorb 90 ml of water. Only 10 ml of water is remaining in the third beaker or C beaker. So we can conclude that this towel, the towel present in the C beaker, is quality of towel because it absorbed more amount of water. So we can say that if the water is absorbed more amount of water, the towel is absorbed more amount of water, that towel is a quality of towel. This is the simple experiment. Aravind and Sweta. Next, we'll discuss about ready to learn.
Vocabulary, pronunciation of the words, how to pronounce the word, how to read, and feelings comes under this before readings. Read the title of the sections in side headings. Those also comes under the reading. And during reading, details for the next paragraphs. For example, in your textbook, they have in page number 10, the differences between the plants and animals, ecosystem they have given. Let open your textbook, page number 10. So, let us observe the following table of endangered species. What is endangered species? What is endangered species? So they are not vanished from the earth. In
future they may vanish. Such type of animals are called endangered species. Plants and animals. There are so many examples they have given during readings and asking questions. And after readings, biotic components. What is biotic components? Producers, consumers, decomposers. So we should summarize what we have read during reading. After reading, we have to summarize it. So let's go to this page number 10 and 11. So endangered species. We will discuss this endangered species in next class. The desert ecosystem and biotic components. So this is about before reading, during reading, and after reading. Writing to communicates. Writing to communicates. Sindhar. In writing, informative writing, in narrative writing, in expressive writing, in persuasive writing is there. Informative writing, narrative writing, expressive writing like poems, narrative is nothing but story, and informative is nothing but observations like this. Interface and conclusions. So the last one is persuasive writings. And it's about letters and important issues on the science. These are writing to communicate. Four different sort of writings. Next one is measuring, using numbers, interpreting data. The last one is using numbers. Just I will show you directly because let's open your page number 12. Measuring, using numbers, interpreting data using numbers, sense. So measuring, what is measuring? Scientists, while they are measuring, they need so many instruments. When we are measuring liquids, we need like your test tubes, beakers. So we need some cloths, timers, thermometers, spring bags, scales. We need such type of measuring instruments. Next one is using numbers. Using number also most important. So, and next one is interpreting data. So, in your page number 12, they given some graph. So, like New Zealand, Australia, USA, Canada, Japan, and India. So, there are some flowcharts they given. Milk production per year. Milk production per year. The highest milk production country in the world. So look at the picture. The highest milk production in the country. Which country is the highest milk production? So which is the Israel country. The Israel country is the highest milk production in the country. The second highest country milk production of milk country is USA, United States of America. The last milk production country is our India. So we are in last. So next is in number sense. Look at this chart, pie charts. So cow's milk and the yellow color, buffalo milk, and the last one is goat, donkey and camel. So from which animal we will get highest milk production? So the orange color, cows. From the cows we will get highest milk production. And the second place is yellow, it indicates buffaloes. From buffalo we will get second highest milk production. The last one is goat, donkey and a camel. The students, let's observe this.
pictures in your textbook. How scientists will measure, how they will use numbers, and interpreting the data and using number sense. Okay, thank you for this class today. Homework is today homework. Just read Arvind plans to investigate on how Arvind uses process skill. How Sweta uses process skill and how what Sweta wanted to investigate. Just you read once and just you write this Arvind experiment and the Sweta experiment. Thank you.